Good morning to everyone. In this section, we are going to discuss about the basics of metrology, which is a major paper for 5th semester BE Mechanical Engineering students affiliated to the Anna University colleges. In this presentation, metrology of measurements, we have taken up an initiative to illustrate briefly some of the important aspects which people usually come across during measurements and instrument handling. The effect shows various methodologies, terminologies with their practical importance. We have also discussed various methods in which measurements errors are observed and easy way of measuring fundamentals and their proper usage. Introduction to metrology. The word metrology is derived from two Greek words. Metra means measurement, logi means science. Thus, metrology is the science of measurement. Metrology can also be defined as the field of knowledge concerned with measurements and include both theoretical and practical problems with reference to measurements. Metrology can also be defined as the process of making precise measurements of the relative positions and orientation of different optical and mechanical components. Measurements encompasses different fields such as communication, energy, medical science, food science, trade, transportation, and military applications, etc. Next, objectives of metrology. The basic objectives of metrology is to provide accuracy at minimum cost. Through evaluation of newly developed product and to ensure that components are within the specified dimension, to determine the process capabilities, to assess the measuring instruments capabilities and ensure that they are adequate for the specific measurements, to reduce the cost of inspection and rejection and rework, to standardize the measuring methods, to maintain the accuracy of measurement through periodical calibration of the instruments, to prepare design for gauges and special inspection fixtures. Next, we'll be seeing about the need of inspection. To ensure the materials, parts and components conform to the established standards, to meet the interchangeability of manufacture, to provide the means of finding the problem areas for meeting the established standards, to produce the parts having acceptable quality levels with reduced scraps and wastages, to purchase good quality of raw materials, tools and equipment that govern the quality of finished product. Next, we'll be seeing about the various elements of metrology. First, in that we'll be seeing what is a standard. It is a most basic element of measurement, without which no measurement is possible. Standard is a physical representation of unit of measurement. Different standards have been developed for various units, including fundamental units. Next, we'll be seeing about workpiece. Workpiece is the object to be measured. In that, variation in geometry and surface finish of the measured parts directly affects measuring system repeatability. Next, it's an instrument. Instrument is a device with the help of which the measurement can be done. The instrument must be selected based on the tolerance of the parts to be measured, the type of environment and the skill level of operator. Next, we'll be seeing about the person. There must be some person or mechanism to carry out the measurement. Modern gauges are increasingly easy to use, but the failure to adequately train the operator personally will lead a poor performance. Next, we'll be seeing about environment. The measurement should be performed under standard environment. Example, temperature, dirt, humidity, vibrations are the four environmental factors that influences the measurement. Next, we'll be seeing about the elements of generalized measurement system. In this diagram, you can notice that the primary sensing element sends a signal. From that, it is being transmitted to the variable conversion element. In that, the conversion has been carried over. From the conversion element, it goes to the manipulation element. From the manipulation element, you can notice that it goes to the processing element, and from the processing element, you can notice that it goes to the transmission system, and finally, it is being presented out. In detail, we'll be seeing in the next slide. First, what is a primary sensing element? It is an element receives signal of the physical quantity to be measured as input. It converts the signal to a suitable form. Next, we'll be seeing what is a variable conversion element. It converts the output of the primary sensing element to a more suitable form. It is used only if necessary. Next, variable manipulation element is it manipulates and amplifies the output of the variable conversion element. It also removes noise in the signal. Next, we'll be seeing what is a data processing element. It is the processing element that the signal received from the variable manipulation elements and produces suitable output. Data processing element may also be used to compare the measured value with a standard value to produce required output. Next, we'll be seeing about data transmission system. Data transmission system is simply used for transmitting data from one element to another. It acts as a communication link between different elements of the measurement system. Next, we'll be seeing about data presentation element. It is used to present the measured physical quantity in a human readable form to the observer. It receives proceed signal from data processing element and presents the data in a human readable form. Next, we'll be seeing what is an accuracy. Accuracy may be defined as the ability of an instrument to respond to a true value of measured variable under the reference condition. It refers how closely the measured value agrees with the true value. Next, we'll be seeing precision. What is a precision? Precision may be defined as the degree of exactness for which an instrument is designed or intended to perform. It refers to the repeatability or consistency of measurement when the measurements are carried out under identical conditions. Next, we'll be seeing about effects of elements of metrology on precision and accuracy. First factor affecting is the standard of measurement. Under that, coefficient of thermal expansion, calibration interval of geometrical compatibility affects. Next factor we'll be seeing is the workpiece to be measured. That is a coefficient of thermal expansion of material, elastic property of a material, cleanliness, surface finish, surface defects such as scratches, waviness is also one of the factors. Next factor is the characteristic of an instrument. Under that, the repeatability and readability, calibration factors, error of friction, zero drift, backlash, etc. Next factor is person. The person should be trained or skilled, or the ability to select the measuring instruments and the standard attitudes towards accuracy is also the important factor. Next, the factors affecting environment are temperature, humidity, atmosphere, pressure, etc. Clean surroundings and minimum vibration enhance precision. High accuracy can be achieved only if all the source of error due to the above five elements in the measuring system are analyzed and steps taken to eliminate them. Next, we'll be seeing about errors in measurements. During measurement, several types of errors arises. An error may be defined as the difference between the measured value and the actual value. Next, what is an absolute error? Absolute error is the algebraic difference between the measured value and the true value of the quantity measured. What is a relative error? It results as a result of the absolute error and the value of comparison used for the calculation of absolute error. Next, we'll be seeing about the types of errors in measurement system. First, we'll be seeing what is a measurement error. It is a result of the variation of a measurement of the true value. Next, what is a systematic error? The error that occurs due to fault in the measuring device are known as systematic error. This systematic error may be classified into different category. First one is the instrumental error, second one is the environmental error, third one is the observational error. First, let us see what is an instrumental error. Instrumental error occurs due to wrong construction of the measuring instrument. Next, what is an environmental error? It occurs due to some external condition of the instrument. Next, observation error. As the name suggests, this type of errors occurs due to wrong observations or reading in the instruments, particularly in case of energy meter reading. Next, we'll be seeing about the methods of measurements. First, we'll be seeing about direct method. In this method, the quantity to be measured is directly compared with the primary or secondary standards. Next one is the indirect method. In this method, the value of quantity is obtained by measuring other quantities that are functionally related to the required value. Example, angle measurement using sine bar. Next, we'll be seeing about what is an absolute method. In this method, the measurement is based on the measurement of base quantities used to define the quantity. Next, what is a comparative method? In this, the quantity to be measured is compared with the known value of the same quantity or any other quantity practically related to it. Example, dial indicator. Next, we'll be seeing about deflection method. In this method, it involves the indication of the value of the quantity to be measured by deflection of a pointer on a calibrated scale. Example, pressure measurement. Next, we'll be seeing about what is a contact method. In this method, the surface to be measured is touched by the sensor or measuring tip of the instrument. Example, micrometer, vernier caliper, dial indicator, etc. Next we'll be seeing about contactless method. As the name indicates, there is no direct contact with the surface to be measured. Example, toolmaker's microscope, profile projectors, etc. Next we'll be seeing about the characteristics in metrology. First we'll be seeing about it is the ratio of the magnitude of output signal to the magnitude of input signal. Next we'll be seeing what is in range. It is the minimum and maximum value of a quantity for which an instrument is designed to measure. Next, what is on span? It is the algebraic difference between the higher calibration value and lower calibration value. Next, what is in repeatability? It is the ability of the measuring instrument to give the same value every time. The measurement of a given quantity is repeated. Next we'll be seeing about standards. A standard is defined as something that is set up and established by an authority as rule of the measurement of quantity, weight, extent, value or quality. For example, a meter is a standard established by an international organization for measurement of length. Industry, commerce, international trade in modern civilization would be impossible without a good system of standards. Next we'll be seeing about role of standards. The role of standard is to achieve uniform, consistent and repeatability measurements throughout the world. Today our entire industrial economy is based on the interchangeability of the parts, the method of manufacture. To achieve this, a measuring system adequate to define the feature of the accuracy required and the standard of sufficient accuracy to support the measuring system are necessary. Next, we'll be seeing about the different types of standards. There are different types of standards. Example, line standard, end standard, wavelength standard. First, we'll see what is a line standard. Line standard, the measurement of distance may be made between two parallel lines or two surfaces. When a length is measured between as the distance between centers of two engraved lines, it is called line standard. Example, standard meters. Next, we'll be seeing about end standard. The need of an end standard arises as the use of line standards and their copies were difficult at various places in workshop. These are usually in the form of end bars and slip gauges. Next we'll be seeing about wavelength standard. Line and end standards are physical standards and are made up of material that can change the size with temperature and other environmental condition. For such suitable unit of length, wavelength source is established. Laser is a source as primary level wavelength standard. Thank you. If there is any clarification, you can contact me through my email ID. Thank you.